श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः चल रहे हैं. यू आर इन यूनिट 5 एंड वी गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू रिवैल्यू योर एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू एडमिट अ पार्टनर इन टू योर फर्म. ऑलराइट, व्हेन अ पार्टनर इज एडमिटेड इन टू द फर्म, वी सॉ देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ एडजस्टमेंट्स दैट यू हैव टू मेक. राइट, द फर्स्ट एडजस्टमेंट वॉज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस एंड शेयरिंग द रिजर्व्स एंड सरप्लसेस एंड लॉसेस. And the second one is revaluation of assets and liabilities. Now, why should you revalue the assets and liabilities? So that you get a true picture, true view of the state or affair of the firm. And moreover, the gain that is arising before this particular partner is admitted in the firm belongs to the old partner. So you should revalue assets and liabilities so that whatever is due to the old partner goes to him. Fine. Assets as well as the liabilities. Now, when a new partner is admitted, you have to revalue. Now, how are you supposed to revalue? So, we're going to do how to revalue your assets and liabilities. Now, just imagine this is the ledger. Okay, this is a revaluation account. Revaluation account. Okay, and the ledger. You have your debit and you have your credit. So, towards your credit side, if there is an increase in the assets, you put it in the credit side, increase in assets, decrease in liabilities, increase in assets, will come to your credit side. So likewise, increase in liabilities and decrease in assets will come to your debit side. Remember this. Okay. And towards your debit side, to profit, you will have profit on revaluation that will be transferred to the old partners in the old profit sharing ratio. Now, by loss arising from revaluation will be again shared with the old partners in the old profit sharing ratio. In the old ratio. Fine. Okay. So, revaluation account, this is how you are supposed to prepare. Whatever increase in assets is, you are going to put it in the credit side. Whatever decrease in the liability, you are going to put it in the credit side. This is only a shortcut what I am teaching you. Fine. Now let us go to the problem. As we go to the problem, we'll be able to understand the problem even better. Fine. Now you have illustration number 4. Rajesh and Ramesh are partners sharing profit and loss in the ratio 3:2. Fine. And Raman is admitted as a new partner and the new profit sharing ratio is decided as 5:3:1. So old profit sharing ratio is 3:2. New profit sharing ratio is 5:3:2. So you have 3/5 and here you have 2/5. Okay. And new profit sharing ratio is 5:3. Following revaluation has to be calculated. Now before passing our journal, let us pass the ledger. From the ledger we can easily post the journals. So let us do our revaluation account. So revaluation account. So revaluation account. Okay, this is your debit side and this is your credit side. Fine, now this is your debit and this is your credit. You have your particulars, rupees, both columns, particulars, rupees, and then you want, you can add one more column, not an issue. If you are getting a profit, it will come to the debit side. If it's going to be a loss, it will go to the credit side. Okay. Now, let us do the first one. Value of the building is increased by rupees 15,000. So value of the building is increased. So there's increase in the asset. So there's increase in the asset. Now here, increase in the asset. So it has to go to the credit side. So buy building. So buy building account. So that is some 15,000. Fine. Now next is what? The value of machinery is reduced. So, reduction in the assets. See here, reduction in the assets. To your debit side. So, to machinery. To machinery account. So, that is how much? 4,000. Okay. The value, provision for bad and doubtful debts is made for 1,000. So, provision for doubtful debts. It's a liability, isn't it? So, any provision. So, provision for doubtful debts is made for. That means increase in your liability. So, increase in liability also here to the debit side. So, two. Two provision for bad and and doubtful debts, which are writing in a short form 1,000 rupees. Okay, now that you have your ledger here, so which side is more? Which side you have more? Let us balance it. 15,000. Always you draw a line and balance. So this side is more, so you got 15,000. So you're getting a profit or loss? You're getting a profit. So 15 minus 5,000, 10,000 is your profit. So to profit on what? To profit on revaluation. Transfer to whose capital account? To transfer to, you have two partners here. Who are they? Ramesh and Rajesh, right? To Rajesh and Ramesh's capital account. To Rajesh and Ramesh's capital account. Capital account. Fine. So how are you going to share this 10,000? 10,000. The profit sharing ratio is 3:2. So 3/5. 10,000 into 2/5. 5 will go here. 2,000 times. So 6,000 to Ramesh account. So balance here you have 4,000. 4,000 will go to, this is Rajesh, this is Ramesh. Right. So we have shared their revaluation. By revaluation, evaluating the assets and liabilities, you have shared the profit arising from revaluation among the old partners in the old profit sharing ratio. Now that you have done the ledger, is it easy for you to pass a journal entry? So I'll tell you how to pass a journal entry. Revaluation account data to missionary account. Revaluation account data to provision for bad and doubtful account. Then building account data to revaluation account. Then revaluation account data to Rajesh's capital account and to Ramesh's capital account, being profit transferred to their respective capital account. Now I'll teach you how to transfer the journal, right? Now let us come to the journal part. Okay, just reducing the screen so that it's visible for you. Okay, now let us pass the journal. Now you have here. Okay, journal. So journal entry. Okay, journal entry. Now for journal entry, you're going to pass the first journal building account data. Same, you have date, particulars, ledger, folio, and of course debit and credit in rupees. Building account. Building account data to revaluation account. Fine. Being appreciation on building. Appreciation on building recorded. Fine. Next you have revaluation to account data to missionary account to provision for bad and doubtful debts account. Okay. Being decrease. Decrease in assets recorded. Okay, the decrease in assets and provision for bad and doubtful debts. That's recorded. So how much is that actually? You have missionary 4,000 rupees, and you have provision for bad and doubtful debts, so that comes to 5,000. So now for building, you have 15,000 now. 15,000. and the profit, revaluation account debtor 2. Here you have 2, right? 2, Ramesh Capital and Rajesh Capital. So, revaluation account debtor 2, Rajesh Capital account 2, Ramesh Capital account. So that comes to 6,000, isn't it? 10,000. So 6,000 and 7,000. So there you are. You have completed the problem. So see here, you have your ledger. Okay, and then you have passed your journal. You can pass from your journal also to your ledger. So either way, but if you pass your ledger, it is easy for you. You will not miss any of the journal. If you pass the journal first, there will be a tendency for you to forget the journal, so you may not get your ledger amount. Right. So, thank you, children. This is your illustration 4. Next, I'll be teaching you exercise problem number 4. Okay. Hope you understood. Thank you.